If you would have asked me about 5 years ago who inspired me the most or what inspired me the most, I would tell you my cousin Jasmine. And it's been that way since high school. She, you know, graduated from high school, went to college, got a job that she absolutely loves and is still able to enjoy her hobbies. Just, you know, a pretty standard life, if you ask me. And at the time, I thought it was everything that I wanted to do with my life. Like, it was literally the American dream, I feel like, for me. But then when it was my turn to graduate from high school and go to college, I realized that I didn't want those things. My values weren't the same values as her. So I just kept imagining, you know, did I want to work a 9-to-5 Monday through Friday? Did I want to go to work, come home, and then go right back to work? It started to sound, you know, very mundane, like such a routine. And at that time, that's not what I wanted. That's not what I wanted for me. And don't get me wrong, I love Jasmine to death. She's like my sister. But early on, I learned that I didn't enjoy the things that she enjoyed, and that I needed to live my life for me. This is when my inspiration sort of shifted and I became inspired by the future. Currently, my future for me is my daughter wanting for nothing and feeling safe and provided for in every aspect of her life. Now, going back, as I was making my way through college, you know, how I've stumbled upon this inspiration and how it stuck with me is whenever I saw something that I wanted and, you know, I was like, okay, I'm gonna get that. I put myself in a position to get that. And that mentality followed me through college, you know, so far through college. You know, I wanted my own apartment. Once I, you know, transferred back to North Carolina, I did that. I wanted a car so that I can get to and from campus. I saved up money, got me a car. Once I was finished with school at the time, I wanted a place for me and my daughter, saved up the money, got me and her, you know, an apartment. That inspiration followed me through many different situations. There was no, I guess you could say my daughter was the person I was doing it for, but there was no person that was like, hey, let me be like this person, I guess, and get what I needed to get. And so it was more like, I see it, I want it, I get it. I apply to just about everything I do, and that's what pushes me to become successful. There's no story that a person can tell me about their life that will light a spark faster than me seeing something that I want and going to get it. Yeah, it can be a materialistic way of thinking, if you think about it, but it's how I've gotten to where I am today. And in the future now, like I said, I imagine my daughter, like, we're in a home that's that home. All her friends want to come, you know, hang out. Yeah, you know, Naomi's house is really cool. And that image is what's pushing me hard to get my degree, start a career, and just be successful.